beginning with John chapter 15 verse 30, as quoted by my brother Shurosh, where Jesus, in answering Philip, he says, "If you have seen me, you have seen the Father," which by reasoning the Christian thinks that Jesus is the Father. But if we look at it in its context again, there are a series of misunderstandings from the very word go. Chapter 14 begins with that misunderstanding, and the misunderstanding of the disciple continues. Chapter 14, it says, Jesus is telling his disciples, "And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know." You know where I'm going, and you know how to get there. So the disciples say, "Master, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way?" They misunderstood. Jesus was speaking about spiritual journey. They are thinking of geographical locations, like Dundee, Newcastle, where? Southampton. He is talking about God and going to God. So Jesus says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me." This was too heavy for them. They couldn't follow what he's talking about. So he says, "Lord, show us the Father and it sufficeth us. It will be enough. Just show us God. We want to see God with our bodily eyes, and that will be our satisfaction enough." In answer to that, Jesus says, "Philip, you have been with me for so long. You are a Jew. As a Jew, you ought to know better than that, that no man can see God and live. God is not seen at any time. And you, being with me for 3 years, you still haven't understood my mission. You want to see God with your physical eyes when you can't even look at the sun. If you have seen me, you have seen the Father." Meaning, if you understood me, you would understand what God is. And this is the language he's speaking ever and anon. He says, "Seeing they see not, hearing they hear not, neither do they understand." This seeing is not physical seeing. If you understood what I am, you would have understood what God is. You wouldn't make such a silly request. He is not claiming to be the Father.